Hello, this is Shweta. Welcome to my classes. Today we will deal with the KI-H2O system, that is a two component system. So here KI is one component and H2O is the other component. It is also called as a salt water system. Why? Because KI acts as a salt here. So here this is the diagram which I have plotted for KI-H2O system. And one of the important feature before going to the system, we will remember that here I have shown the point A. Point A is what? I have shown here melting point of ice. It is either the melting point of ice or freezing point of water, you can say. Either of one you can say. But for B, B is the melting point of KI. I have not shown that. So actually it should coincide with this vertical axis, isn't it? But I have not shown. Why? Because the melting point of KI is very high. It acts as a salt and the melting point of KI is very high. It is not possible to show in this figure. So somewhere like imaginary point B will be, you have to imagine. So I have not coincided that with the vertical point. That you have to remember. Clear? And here your temperature axis goes and here your composition axis goes. Here composition I have plotted here. Here is a 100% water. Why? Because melting point of ice is here. So here it is 100%. As you go on here, it will become 0. Similarly here KI will be 0. And as you go on here, here what happens? Your KI percentage increases. Clear? I have taken in percentage form. So if it is percent, then we will move from 0 to 100. You can take either in a mole fraction. If you take in mole fraction, then it will be from 0 to 1. You can take either of 1. But I have taken in terms of percentage. So I am taking from 0 to 100. Okay. But here you know that in this 3 degrees of freedom is required. But 1 degree, we have kept it as constant. Throughout this 2 component system, you have to remember that one of the variable is kept constant. 1 degrees of freedom is kept constant. That is, P is kept constant. In this whole of the system, your P is kept constant and temperature and composition versus diagram is plotted. So this is the explanation. So here also, as we learnt in the one component system, we had areas, curves, triple point. Here also in this system we will learn areas, curves, and instead of triple point we will learn your eutectic point. So one by one we have to study all these three. But before learning these, we will try to understand the system. So, to understand this diagram, what we will do? So, let us, here I have written as solution. Why I have written this as solution? If I take any composition, think that I am taking a point somewhere here. So, first I am taking a point somewhere here. So, here your both KI as well as water will be in solution form. Why? Because here below this temperature it is solid. Above this temperature it will be definitely in liquid state. So, here I have taken a solution in which both your KI as well as your KI as well as your water are in the solution form. So think that we will go at this point somewhere. So here it is like 90% and 10%. So 90% KI H2O, we are taking 90% H2O and 10% KI. Okay, what we did? We took this mixture, 90% H2O and 10% KI mixture, and we have heated vigorously. Very high we have heated. Means above this temperature, 0 degree Celsius, we have heated. So now it is in the solution form. Okay, so what I do? Slowly I'll go on decreasing the temperature. Actually, what should happen? Here, at this point, what should happen? Your ice should melt, isn't it? Your ice should get solidified. Why? Because it is 0 degree Celsius, freezing point. So your ice should get freezed, but it is not happening so. Here it is getting freezed, isn't it? Your curve is here. It is showing the point here. So why it is showing the point here? Because there is a depression in the freezing point. Why there is a depression in freezing point? Because your KI acts as a solute. You know that if any solute is added to the solution, then there will be a decrease in the freezing point. That depression in freezing point is observed here. So what I will get? I will get a depression in freezing point here. Clear? Then what I do? So it will be like this. So this solution, what I do? Again I will cool this solution. If I cool this solution below this temperature, what happens? If I cool this solution, think that this is the concentration I'm getting. Okay, if I cool this solution, I'll get this. So if I want the concentration, then I'll take. So it will be which concentration? It will be 80 and 20%. So what has happened? If I cool this mixture, then definitely my whatever the water is there, it will get solidified. Means this water will become in the form of ice. Then what happened? Your water content get reduced, isn't it? Think that. Just assume your 90% water became 80% water and got the ice cubes and it got settled. And your whatever the solute is there, no? KI, that will increase. Means here amount will not increase. Remember, here amount will not increase, only the percentage composition will increase. Why? Because your water is getting solidified in the form of ice. So your 90% water got reduced to 80% and 10% Ki got reduced to 20%. Again, then what you will do? Now you got 80-20%, again you take this concentration and again you put. You will get the mixture of what? You will get the mixture of 70-30. Again, what happens? Again, if you start cooling this, what happens? Again, your ice cubes will be coming off. Why? Because this water again solidifies. So again, you will get ice cubes. Then just assume that you are getting 70% of H2O and 30% of Ki. You are getting 70% of H2O and 30% of Ki. Just you remember that as you go on decreasing the temperature, from here, as you go on decreasing the temperature, your ice will get solidified. I mean, your water will get solidified. Clear? So here, 90% to 80%, 80% to 70% it became. At the same time, your percentage composition of Ki will be increasing. So it will be 10%, 20%, 30%, so on. So like this, it will go on increases. Again, if go on increasing like this only, so at some point what happens, you will reach the composition such that it will be 50% and 50%. Your 50% H2O and your 50% Ki. You will reach this system. So 50% H2O will be there, 50% Ki will be there. So there what happens is, like whatever is your, as water is getting slowly outside, so here 50% like H2O you got and 50% Ki you got. So what you are observing is that, so your water percentage is go on decreasing. It means what? Your Ki is become saturated. So solution is saturated. Now you are going towards the saturated solution. Whenever you go to the saturated solution, so what happens at one point? Think that actually for the system, no? It is at minus 23 degrees Celsius. At minus 23 degrees Celsius, what happens? Along with the solidification of H2O, at minus 23 degrees Celsius, along with the solidification of H2O, you will also observe the solidification of Ki. So what happens? Both will start getting solidified. Even water as well as Ki. So that time, that point is called as a eutectic point, that is observed as O. So now O is nothing but your eutectic point, at which both your H2O as well as Ki will get solidification. So at this composition I have written 52% Ki and 48% H2O. What you are having? You are having the eutectic point O at minus 23 degree Celsius. This is called as a eutectic temperature and this is called as a eutectic composition. Okay. So this is your eutectic composition. So eutectic point is nothing but the easy melting point. So there melting of both the liquids takes, both the whatever solids are there, it will take place easily. So above this degree, so it was only your ice was getting, your water was getting solidified, isn't it? But now at this point O, what happens? Both your Ki as well as H2O at this degree, at this temperature and at this composition, it is getting a solidified. So both, so I have written below this degree what happens? Both will remain in solid form only. Your ice as well as your Ki, both will be in the solid form. Hence, before below this minus 23 degrees Celsius, whatever temperature range it might be, so both your Ki also will be in the solid form and your water also will be in your solid form. But in this range, in this curve, what happened? Your solution was there. Along with that, only your ice was getting solidified, isn't it? Your ice was coming and it was getting solidified here. So at only this point O, your eutectic composition is observed. Even this can be explained coming from that side also. So here what happens, here see, if I am coming solution, I am taking what? Like 10% water I am taking. I am taking only 10% of water. In only 10% of water, I am mixing 90% of Ki. Think that I am taking only little quantity of water, very little quantity of water is there. Only this much quantity of water is there. I am putting 90% of Ki, means much of the Ki I am adding. So Ki I am adding means, is it possible easily to dissolve this? No. To achieve this solution, we have to raise the temperature much high. So you have to increase this and you have to make very super saturated. So it is called as a super saturated. What do you do in super saturated? We will take water, little water, and you take little substance and then we will mix. Again you will increase the temperature, again you will add solid, and then by increasing the temperature very high, think that I am increasing the temperature up till here. I'll take a point here, I am increasing the temperature and have achieved the super saturated solution. Okay. Now I have mixed my 90% of Ki in 10% of water. Now just imagine, if I cool, if I start cooling, which one of will come first? Definitely your 90% Ki will come. If I am getting the temperature reduced. If I reduce the temperature, your 90% Ki out of 90%, first Ki will get solidified. Why? Because forcibly we have increased the temperature and we have made this to get soluble in water. So which will get solidified first? Your Ki will get solidified first. So if I take this here, which will come out? Your Ki will come out as a solid. Hence I have written here solid Ki. Your solution will be there and I have written solid Ki. Again, if you get certain composition, I take this and I will cool again. If I cool again this, again what happens? Here 90% Ki out of that thing that your 80% Ki is out. Then percentage of water will be increased, 20% H2O. Similarly, again if I cool this, I'll get 70% Ki, 30% water. So on again, this composition is reached at which both of your ice as well as Ki will get separated. First, we will discuss about curves now. Okay. So, as you know that we will discuss about curves, areas, eutectic point in this. First, we will see curves. So, can you see how many curves are there? From the diagram, you can see that there are two curves. One is OA curve and other is OB curve. So, curve OA and OB. So, now OA curve is called as a freezing point curve of water. Why? Because this where water gets freezed into ice. So, it is called as a freezing point curve of water. And what about OB? OB curve is called as a solubility curve of Ki. Why? Because it shows the solubility of Ki, isn't it? As your temperature goes on increases. You can see here, as your temperature goes on increases, your solubility of Ki in water is also increasing. Hence, it is called as a solubility curve of Ki. And you know that. Now, you have to find the degrees of freedom, isn't it? So, F equal to dash. You have to find the degrees of freedom along these curve OA and OB. To find degrees of freedom, we should know the component. Component is 2. As it is 2 component system, you know that C equal to 2. Now the question is to find number of faces, isn't it? So P equal to 4. So now can you see here for this curve, no, your solution phase is in equilibrium with this solution plus ice phase. And for this curve also, your solution phase is in equilibrium with this phase. Means for both the curves, there are 2 phases in equilibrium, isn't it? So here you can see the equilibrium side. So here 2 phases are there. So P will be equal to 2. Now, you should apply reduced Gibbs phase rule, not Gibbs phase rule, you should apply reduced phase rule, which is that? That is, F dash is equal to C minus P plus 1. Why you are using this F dash? Because you have kept the pressure as constant. You can see my last video, then you will get to know why you have kept pressure as constant. So, by substituting now C and P, you will get F. That is, C equal to 2, P equal to 2 plus 1. Here, 2 will get cancelled. You are remained with F dash is equal to 1, which implies it is a monovariant system. Monovariant means what? Only 1 degree of freedom you are required to find the you ought to define the point in the curve. Yes or no? Either if you tell composition, I can tell the temperature, or if I know the temperature, I can tell the composition. How is that? See, if I tell you this temperature, then you will go and coincide with the curve and you will find out the composition. So either of one variable is required, that is said to be a monovariant. This completes the curves. Now, we can see areas. Now, you have 4 areas here. So, one by one, we will see. First, see AOD. Can you see here? AOD. This is one of the area and BOD dash. So, BOD dash. This is another area and below DD dash means here. This below DD dash and above AOB means what? AOB. Here is also one area. So, now, in all the areas, you have to see how many number of faces are there. At least components you know. Components are how many? Components are 2. So, your C equal to 2. You have to find F equal to what? Before going to that, we will discuss P equal to what? Clear? So, in AOD you can see. In AOD means which is that area? In AOD, in this area, what you can observe is that it represents the equilibrium between the solution as well as the liquid A. Isn't it? There is an equilibrium between solution and liquid A. So what happens? The composition of these faces in the equilibrium can be obtained by drawing a horizontal line at one particular point. Whatever the line where it cuts the curve, no, that will tell the nature of the solid. Okay? So that will be the same explanation for this side also. So there will be only one faces. And for this curve, below DD dash means here below DD dash, always it will be in the solid phase only. Because below eutectic, they both, whatever the temperature it may be, they will be always in the solid phase. And above AOB, you can see here, above AOB, here it is always in the solution phase. Means how many faces are there? In everywhere you can see only one phase. So your P will be equal to 1. So now which rule you are going to apply? You are going to apply reduced phase rule. What is that? F dash is equal to C minus P plus 1. What is your C? Your C is 2. Faces are 1 plus 1. It will be 2 minus 1 is 1 plus 1. Your F dash is equal to 2. Means degrees of freedom equal to 2. Which means it is a bivariate system. Means you want 2 degrees of freedom. It means what? If I want to locate any point in the area, I want temperature also and I want composition also. That is how. So this is temperature, right? If I want to define this point, I want this also and this also. This is the meaning of F equal to 2. So now last we will study the eutectic point. You know that in the diagram, O is the eutectic point. So where O, how O is formed? So by intersection of AO and BO, your point O is formed. At this point, you see, three faces are in equilibrium. Which are those? KI in solid form, H2O in solid form, that is ice, and solution. All the three faces are in equilibrium. So for eutectic point, what happens? Your P will be equal to 3, C will be equal to 2. Then how about F? You are going to find using Gibbs phase rule. That is, F is equal to C minus 3 plus 1. C is what? 2 minus 3 plus 1. It will be minus 1 plus 1. Which implies what? Both will get cancelled. Your F dash will be equal to 0. This is reduced phase rule. So your F dash will be equal to 0. Which implies invariant. Invariant means it doesn't require any degrees of freedom. Directly I can tell this O is the degrees of freedom. This completes KIH2O system. Please do share, subscribe and like my channel and tap the bell icon to get notified. Thank you.